previously on Game of Thrones.
Ooh, guess what? Go guess. Go on, you can do it. You can do it. That's right! It's me, Butter, and we're back! With yet another goddamn episode!
Trouble. Lord White
Game of Thrones. Garrison of 20 this time it's episode 3!
You have a man you trust?
Tress!
My son, Griff.
And
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure Ironwood from...
Holy shit, that last episode! Oh my god, I'm still...
on such an alliance.
I'm literally and recording... Episode 2 and Episode 3 back to back.
For me might prove
oh my god.
Dangerous for you and your house.
That episode made me hurt. It did. That fucking...
I'm going to kill you.
Funeral pyre scene.
Is that so?
Oh my god.
I'm glad I found you, my boy. It's been far too long.
Who the fuck is he?
Who the my fuck own... are you? Anyway.
Roderick. By the gods, it is you.
Shit's getting fucking interesting, though, isn't it?
Fetch the maester, hurry!
Oh my god. So fucking excited!
Let her go!
Oh, tall boy! I still can't believe that there was 10% of everyone that's played this game who are sick fucking bastards who let Cold Boy die.
And the Lost Legion won't stop until you and your friend are dead.
Protect your neck, bitch. Anyway, so yeah, I'm recording these two back to back, so I'm still a little bit sauce from the last episode, and I'm fucking hyped up. Even though the last episode ended on a very sad note.
She's been gone a while.
I'm fucking keen.
If they catch her, they'll kill her.
She'll come back.
Catch her.
She's costing us time. It's just that we need to get to Marina.
I know,
every day
Uncle.
Lose here is a day that Talia or Ryan could be hurt, or worse. You must return home safely, Asher. And well, you have a history of putting your faith in women who may not deserve it.
But Beskar's hot. I'm still shipping them. They are shipped.
She's my friend, Uncle. She's been at my side for a long time.
Was it them? The Lost Legion?
Aye. Too many for us to take. I counted about 24, maybe more, as well as horses. About half a mile down the canyon, and coming fast. Had to run my ass off to avoid getting caught. It's nearly empty. You two care if I finish it off?
It might be a while before we find more water.
Dying, though.
Nah. Drink up.
Thanks.
I'm gonna look after Beskar. Because I'm shipping this!
We need to get moving.
Shipping it! Deal with it. They should totally bang.
The Lost Legion. We're 100 miles from Yunkai. When are they going to give up?
They won't.
Never. They're still raw about T'Zaal.
Ah, fuck him.
Yes, well, perhaps you shouldn't have snapped his neck.
Ah, fuck him!
There is such a thing as overdoing it. Not that I care about T'Zaal.
Let me remind you. It was him who tried to kill us. I just returned the favor.
Oh, don't doubt it. You always did have a gift for that sort of thing.
It's only a matter of time before they overtake us.
Is he taking the piss?
Ah, bugger a harpy.
Wow.
Can we
exactly.
Back?
Not without meeting our mates from Yunkai. We're well and truly fucked this time, Asher.
During severe winters, when the Skahazadan floods, it carves out great underground rivers in the sandstone.
And
when those waters recede, those rivers become caves. And those caves might hide us, if we can find them. I mean, we're trapped for the moment, but all I'm saying is we needn't die here. Just standing our ground.
Thank you, Malcolm. That's valuable advice.
Of course.
If he's right about this, I may actually stab him.
Don't do that.
He's the uncle. We could dig our way through. We'll try to scramble over.
I don't know. Either will be slow and tricky. One wrong move and the whole thing could collapse on us.
I'm not willing to try that.
Well, we can't stay here, waiting for your butchered friends to corner us.
Agreed.
You found anything?
Not yet. What's on your mind?
How do you know all that? About the floods and the caves?
I read all about Essos on the voyage over. Histories of Marine, histories of Slaver's Bay.
Smart man.
I just hope it pays off.
You see? Beska came back. She risked her life out there for us. You trust her now?
This may sound harsh, but Beska's immaterial. I have to put you first. You are all that matters to me, Asher.
Beska matters to me.
So hot for each other.
We all need to pull together if we're going to get out of this and onto Marine. I can't have you and Beska scrapping.
So much riding on this. Talia, Ryan, your mother. You and I are supposed to return to Westeros with a sellsword army, and I haven't the faintest idea how we're going to pull it off. So, if I seem a bit moody, that's why.
We'll pull it off.
Let me know if you find anything.
Do I get to talk to Beska? Aw, man. I'd like to talk to Beska.
What in seven hells did you two do to rile these bastards?
Hey, Beska.
Hush.
I meant to say, thank you. I realize this isn't your fight. And Marine is the last place you'd want to go.
Gods, Asha. Don't go soft on me. Together till we're dead.
Yeah, that's my girl.
Look, Malcolm's all right. I promise. He practically raised me. You know my father and I didn't get along.
Well, he's an odd one. And he doesn't appear to like me much.
He has a lot of things on his mind.
The right things, I hope.
You know anything else about these bastards hunting us?
Well, obviously they hate you.
Thanks. I figured that out on my own.
You've heard the rumor, right?
Hey?
They carve their faces up as an initiation. Flay the skin right off. Looks like they're inside out. That's why they wear those helmets.
That's fucking messed
no.
up.
That's a load of horse shit.
That better be a fucking load of horse shit. Cause that's fucking... That messed
Beska,
up.
If you see anything...
Alright. Look at that. What's that?
What do you think? Could we climb out of here?
Pretty steep, Asha.
And we'd be totally exposed if your friends arrived before we reached the top.
Rock slide looks recent.
It could have been caused by the Targaryen girls 10,000 unsullied marching through here.
No. Something else. Something big did that.
Probably a fucking dragon. Oh, Christ! There's a corpse there!
Looks like we're not alone. No obvious wounds. Maybe he died of thirst. Listen. That's water. I hear water.
From underground. There might be a cave nearby.
Look at this. Gold.
Fat lot of good it did him.
Okay, I'm taking that.
He's not gonna need that.
Asher, the Lost Legion will be here at any moment.
I don't care!
This is Essos. There's always time for gold. Oh, shit. It's them.
Monte Freedom! Que sirinzi!
Shit!
Come on!
Go!
They're behind us.
This was
damn it!
Asher! Find us another way out of here!
Got it!
Well, I might have fucked up in grabbing his gold.
What in seven hells is that smell?
Oh, there's dead things.
Burn. Maybe someone made camp in here and cooked it.
No, I have another theory.
There's a light!
Go! See if there's a way through.
We'll hold them off!
It's a fucking dragon!
I'll come.
Fuck! Shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit! I'm sorry, Malcolm. Burn. I'm sorry, Malcolm.
Asher! From my hand!
Hurry, Asher! It's nearly on you!
Ah! Got there! I wonder if that was Drogon. I'm gonna have a song doing that. Every fucking episode so far, I've tried to do that. Anyway, as I said before, it me, Butter. Welcome to Game of Thrones episode 3! I believe this one's called The Sword in the Darkness. Guess we'll find out in a moment. And holy shit, yeah, so I'm recording this one only moments after I recorded the episode 2, so I might be a little bit hyped and definitely inebriated, because as per the last two episodes, I am still drinking wine. A very poor Arbor Red, if I could say. Oh, there it is. The Sword in the Darkness. That was close. But fucking hell, Game of Thrones. I love it. I love the TV series. I love this game. I'm in love with this game.
Game's so good!
So good! Here we are. We're on the wall. Sir Garrod is,
Listen up, you sorry lot.
Walling about around. The place.
We're handing out assignments today.
Ah, shite!
Garrod.
I hope I got Ranger.
We'll be men of the watch before nightfall. Right. Sorry. No hard feelings over that business with Finn, yeah?
Nah, it's fine, bro.
I appreciate you not ratting me out over the knife.
Don't worry.
It's nice to know there's at least one brother I can trust. Finn might have killed me otherwise.
I wouldn't be much of a friend if I did.
I wasn't much of a friend for dropping you into the mess in the first place. Sorry about that. It won't happen again.
Well,
you better fucking
aren't you
don't.
Two sons of whores looking thick as thieves? Having a good laugh over nicking my knife, eh, Garrod? Men
oh, yes.
like you turn traitor for nothing. It's in your blood. Next, you'll be killing men of the watch for a loaf of bread.
Finn, stop being such a bloody fool.
When a man takes my gear, it'll be
He's
my fist that'll rip their
die.
Heart from their gullets.
You'll always be an asshole, Garrod.
You're just a fucking craven.
Look, it's over, all right? Just drop it.
You can bugger off if you like.
Finn, leave him alone. It wasn't Garrod's fault. If you're gonna hate someone, hate me.
With pleasure.
Now,
fucking
it doesn't matter
Finn.
What the
I
world
mean,
once called
fuck
you.
That guy.
After today, you're all brothers. Could even
and that
be
whole
that
not talking over
the
top of people is going so strong right now.
Or maybe you'll save his.
He says as he talks over the top
Let's
of somebody.
Let's find out then, shall we? Casper to the builders. Finn to the rangers. Eric to the stewards. Hugh to the rangers. Cotter to the builders.
Cotter's a builder.
And finally, Garrod to the rangers.
Yes!
That's it.
Fucking
May
no,
all the
dude.
Preserve you.
Sorry
well,
for your holes.
There we are. I'll be patching up the wall, and you'll be defending it.
Should you northern boys want your gods to give a blessing to this union, there's a weirwood tree beyond the wall. Now form up and follow my lead.
Do we actually... Oh, I'm actually doing that. Okay. I am a northern boy after all. The old gods. Children of the forest. The first men, blah-de-blah-de-blah-da-blah.
Garrod, it's good to hear you'll be a ranger.
Thank you.
I know you wanted this.
I'm ready to say my vows.
Fuck off, Finn, you fucking twat.
I didn't have many friends when I first arrived at Castle Black. Bryn and Pip, they'd have sooner seen me bloodied in the yard than offer a hand. Now, I'd die for either of them.
Well?
Our brothers are all we have.
That makes me feel good, I guess.
Finn.
Shows you what kind of ripe fools are running this place. I can't believe they made you a ranger. You're not fit for the job. You don't have any balls between your legs.
Like it or not, we're brothers now. Means we're gonna have to get along.
Don't count on it. You wouldn't even be here if you didn't have Snow leading you by the hand the whole way.
Mm. I'd keep an eye out for you if you weren't such an ass about everything.
You don't give a shit about me. No one around here gives a shit about me. They wouldn't even care if I... You know how many rangers are never heard from again in these parts? And I'm about to become one myself. All alone out here. Wildlings everywhere.
Then don't worry. You were born to kill wildlings. When I punched you the other day, most men would have gone down like a sack of potatoes. But you gave it right back to me.
I suppose you're right.
You want a different assignment, because I hear they need someone to clean the shithouse.
That's why I'm so fucking mad at you, Garrett. You're the closest thing I have to a friend.
That's okay. We'll be friends, Finn. Let's be friends.
You handled that well, Garrett.
Thank you.
They say the old gods watch us through the weirwoods. More than watchers. They know us. The gods are not forgiving. We brothers have to be. We're here. After this, there's no going back. Now go.
Gotta say me words.
Take your vows.
Fuck.
In the eyes of the old gods, the Night's Watch offers you a place beside us. Now say the words for all to hear and embrace us as your own.
Well, apparently I gotta walk up there. Can't do this the easy mode, apparently. Fucking hell. Keep walking, you twat.
Hear my words.
And bear witness to my vow. Night gathers, and now my watch begins.
It shall not end until my death.
Fucking hell. I shall take no wife. Hold no lands. Father no children.
I shall wear no crowns.
And win no glory.
I shall live and die at my post.
I am the sword in the darkness. Ooh, this is the episode name.
I am the watcher on the walls.
I am the shield, the guards, the realms of men. I pledge my life and honor to the Night's Watch.
For this night and all the nights to come.
I've said my words.
You knelt as boys.
You stand as men!
Rise now as men of the Night's Watch.
I guess I failed. Whatever.
Welcome to your new family, Garrett.
We're men of the watch now. Means we get to piss off the wall whenever we want.
Didn't know you needed an excuse to play with yourself, Finn.
Garrett, you've got a visitor. Over there.
Oh, I've got a visitor.
Well, who is it?
Do I look like your fucking squire?
Nice one. Eh? Ah, it's me fucking uncle. And tell that smarmy prick from the back of his fucking head.
Don't forget the practice shorts.
Uncle Duncan!
Garrett! It's good to see you. They told me you were at the Weirwood Tree. Wasn't sure you'd be back in time.
I've missed you, Uncle. I never expected to see you here.
I've business with the Night's Watch. A delivery of Ironwood shields to keep you all out of harm's way.
Very good.
That settles it, then?
Aye, the delivery looks in order.
The gods do grant miracles. You look well, nephew. I'm told you're a ranger now. That's good.
Uncle?
He's gonna make me do some well fucked up shit, isn't he?
I know. I heard the news about Ethan.
I wasn't there when it happened. Small mercy, I suppose. Not having to see our lord struck down with such barbarity. But House Forrester is nothing if not resilient. Our house has survived centuries. Turn back countless threats.
Let me help, Uncle. I can't just sit here at the wall while our enemies are circling Ironwrath.
That's why I'm really here. Do you recall Lord Forrester's last words to you? Just before he died, Gregor's final command, spoken to you in confidence.
He said the North Grove must never be lost.
Indeed. But first, it must be found.
They don't even know where the fucking thing is. It's in the North.
Scour in the legends for any clue what Lord Forrester knew. I think I found the answer.
Fuck.
Describes a fortification, a protected citadel of sorts, hidden from the world, one filled with great power. It was scattered among his notes.
Oh shit.
Almost an obsession, a vital secret he protected at all costs.
And you think it's north of the wall?
His notes suggest as much. And you must find
that's where
it,
the Garrett. Three-eyed Raven lives.
The search won't be easy. But you're a Tuttle. Our lord knew you wouldn't fail him.
Somewhere north of the wall. That's not a lot to go on, Uncle. How am I supposed to find it?
The first chance you get to head north, take it.
And then?
And then?
Leave the Night's Watch behind. And strike out on your own. This is no small request I make. I know that. But there's no other
choice. You took me vows, you cunt!
Uncle, that's desertion. The Night's Watch execute men who desert.
I know. I wouldn't ask this of you if there was another way. This will help guide you. I found it hidden in Lord Forrester's strongbox.
What is that?
A page from our lord's journal. But one he tore out and kept separate. Why? I don't know.
It's a map. To the North Grove.
Aye.
I used to be frightened of weirwood trees. But before I was a man grown, I swear, I actually could hear them whispering sometimes. You said it was a citadel of some kind. Could this be it? No. No, it couldn't be that easy. It's hidden here somewhere. This looks familiar.
What is it, Garrett?
Talia gave me this. Before I left.
Oh. Wait. Lord Forrester gave Ethan a similar one as well. Roderick, too. I wonder.
Bloody ice dragon. Gods be good. Now that I would love to see.
Look.
There's a clasp.
It must open.
Nothing else? Alright. Open it.
I had no idea this was inside. Another weirwood.
But why?
Maybe it's a key to solving the map.
Pop it on the weirwood tree. Rotate it right.
A perfect fit. Maybe it's telling us where to look on the map.
Well, that doesn't look right. Maybe try another.
Puzzles.
It's the whole map that has to turn.
Aye.
The Werewood's mouth. Uncle, whatever this place is, the North Grove must be near.
There's only one way to find out. Here, take this map. Everything we hold dear may well depend on your success. It's a lot to put on your shoulders. The lives of a whole house.
You can tell everyone at Ironwrath that Garrett Tuttle has taken up the cause.
Your sense of honor is a quality I've long admired, Garrett.
You know what?
God's watch over
Fuck
you.
My vows.
You're the
I only just
I
took
had.
Them. They're fresh.
Let's go.
Buyer's remorse.
I don't know. Probably like little shards.
I hope to never lift one of those again.
Wait, so, like a weapon?
Well, your piss is like any other liquid, I reckon.
Yeah, mine's mostly ale.
And if it froze on the way down the wall, it'd probably break up into little icy bits.
Be moving pretty fast too, wouldn't it?
I suppose.
Wait, so you're saying I could kill a mammoth with my piss?
Oh, you really are as stupid as they say, aren't you?
Well, that was rather mysterious. A stranger arrives and you're chatting him up.
Someone said it was your uncle looking for you. Well, what did he want?
Looked like you two had a lot to talk about.
Must have been important to come to Castle Black.
Is Castellan to House Forrester? They sell ironwood to the builders.
So you were just talking about lumber all that time?
It looked like it gave you something.
It was nothing. Let's go and celebrate.
Already keeping secrets from your brothers, eh?
Ah, shut the fuck up, Finn.
The wall's gonna melt before we get up there. Come on.
Shut the fuck up, Finn, you fucking meathead. I hope they're wearing their warm ones. It's gonna be fucking cold up there otherwise. Oh.
There are so many guests already arriving. And have you seen the wedding decorations
the wedding
they put
day.
Up in the gardens? So beautiful. Oh,
the week of the wedding. One of the two.
You know, we're as lucky as she is. Marjorie was but a lady when we were sent to serve at Highgarden. But in just a few days' time, we'll be attending to a queen at a royal feast. Where we're standing, we'll be able to see everyone. And everyone will be able to see us.
We've certainly come a long way, haven't we?
Yeah, we have.
I've been meaning to say what I told you about my family. It means a lot to be able to share that with someone.
You're a bastard!
Someone I can trust.
You're a bastard, Sarah.
If handmaidens don't help each other in King's Landing, nobody will.
Thank you, Mira. And you know I'll always help you too.
Hold on. I just hope it.
There he is.
Lord Morgrin?
No, next to him. Lord Tarwick. I don't want to be
like
a handmaiden forever.
80!
And this wedding may be the best chance of meeting a husband I'll ever have.
More likely 40.
I have to go talk to
him.
He's
balding, Sarah!
Marjorie won't notice it for a few minutes longer.
The fuck?
Make an excuse for me? Please. I'm not asking for much.
Go on then. It'll be fine. The wedding's still days away.
Thank you, Mira. I knew I could count on you.
Shit's cowboy. Go to him. He's probably got important news.
What are you doing here?
I know I shouldn't be here, but we have to talk. I didn't know when I would see you next.
Look,
my life.
That night, I don't know what might have happened if you hadn't helped me.
Well, I could say the same to you, Lady Mira. But I came here to warn you.
Warn me?
I was down in Fleabottom last night,
when I overheard a couple of Lannister guards talking about...
Shh!
They already know he's missing. Probably dead. They're questioning people. Searching for his body.
Please tell me you took care of it.
Of course. I told you I would. No one will know what you did. What? What is it?
I kept the knife.
If we're gonna survive this...
I still have his knife.
Oh, no. Just keep it hidden and clean the blood off it. Meantime, just stay out of sight.
How? Do you forget who I serve?
Just don't get in any more trouble. And I'll watch your back. We're in this together now.
Why are you helping me?
What do you mean? I'm a friend, Lady Mira. My name's Tom. We help each other, or it's both our heads.
Thank you, Tom.
Don't thank me yet, Lady Mira. There's still a knife out there covered with a dead man's blood.
She didn't...
I don't...
Mira.
My lady.
Really? A tryst in the bushes with that coal boy. Not to say it's wrong, but with all the lords and knights in King's Landing, you just don't want to spoil your chances of a good marriage. Oh, thank the gods you came along, Sarah. That boy. He fancies me. He'll find any excuse to talk. I just don't have the heart to drive him off. So you misled him? I wouldn't waste the time. Come on. Marjorie expects us at the throne room.
I think I got away with that one, guys.
You can tell me all about this Lord Tarwick on the way.
Although,
his name's Garibald, and he has this really funny accent.
Garibald?
It's a clever story about this festival they have where they celebrate.
Cleverest story. Wow.
And I've given the musicians a list of songs to play for Joffrey at the feast. I assume you have no problems with the reigns of Castamere?
I trust you've chosen all the standards. But just to be sure, I'll draw up a list of wedding ballads we favor in Highgarden.
Your Grace, my lady.
Which reminds me, Joffrey will require his Kingsguard close at hand during the feast. I'm afraid we'll have no room for your handmaidens.
But we...
What was that? Do you object? Is that what I heard? If you're going
Your
to
Grace,
speak out of turn, girl...
I...
You should finish what you start.
Sarah's simply in awe of your presence, Your Grace. We're happy to spend the feast wherever it pleases you.
Your happiness is not my concern. I asked your handmaiden here at the Iron Throne whom she would serve if forced to choose between yourself and the king. She chose you. Yet now she puts the king first. I'm surprised you'd let such swings of loyalty go unchecked. In any case, it's settled. The Kingsguard will stay with Joffrey. Your handmaidens will sit elsewhere.
Of course, Your Grace. Anything for my beloved Joffrey.
Lady Marjorie, we may not see eye to eye on everything, but I hope you will at least agree with me that our handmaidens should know their place. And that place is not with my brother, Tyrion.
Son of
What did she mean
bitch.
By that? You and Tyrion. What you do reflects on me. If something's going on, I need to know about it.
Tyrion... He offered to help my family.
He did? Then surely he expects something in return. Sarah, what do you know of this?
Tyrion approached us, my lady. It was his idea, not Mira's.
I don't care what your intentions were, Mira. You went to a Lannister behind my back. I've only ever tried to help you. Why are you making trouble for me?
Fuck!
Please, Lady Marjorie, trust me. I know what I'm doing. I've learned from the best.
I don't have the time or patience for your games, Mira.
Fuck
right
off!
Right now, I need you both to be my handmaidens, and that's all I need you to be.
Fine. bitch.
Let there be no mistake. If I hear of you speaking so much as a word to Tyrion Lannister again, you can go home to your family.
I'm sorry, my lady, I made a mistake. It won't happen again. Please don't send me home.
This can't happen again.
It will happen again. It has to. Now that that's come up, it has to happen again. No, fuck her. She's not even gonna be the queen. Spoilers! Well, that was a noisy dream.
Roderick, it's the White Hills. They're assembling in the courtyard.
Fuck.
They've woken the house. You can't let this go on.
I'll need my sentinel. Go ahead, Talia, and have Roiland meet me in the courtyard.
It's time to get fucking real. Tick tock goes the clock. Fucking loading screens.
What is this?
It's a parade of dead men if I have my way.
I'm with you, Sir Roiland. What the fuck you think you're doing?
What is the meaning of this? I demand to know.
Those are strong words. For a cripple who can't carry a sword?
All of you, show your respect to Griff Whitehill.
Griff.
Fourthborn son of Lord Lud Whitehill and Commander...
Wait, his name's
Lud?
Fourthborn. Fucking fourthborns.
Used to call you. Swinging your prick round, lording it over my family. Now look at you. Hey? Roderick the Ruined.
You've got a wart on your face.
But the name fits, don't it?
Make no mistake, Griff. I'm still the Lord of Ironwrath, and I run this house.
That sounds like the old Roderick, beating his chest every chance he got. I don't think he gets it.
No, my lord. I don't think he does.
Your brother Ethan didn't get it either.
You bite your tongue.
I am in charge now. And the first thing you need to know is that if I am not happy, no one is happy. So my men are taking over your great hall. That's where we'll quarter from now on.
What? You can't.
You'll have to go through me.
I won't have my men sleeping out in your barn in shit and filth. Maybe that's how foresters live, but not us.
I don't care if you're happy or not. You'll quarter where I tell you.
I wasn't fucking asking, Roderick. And what's more, you will treat my men right. I've heard what you've done, and if they're eating wormy bread, then your people better be eating shit off the ground. I'm not here to keep them in line. I'm here to keep you in line.
Your men aren't fucking guests. We'll get what I give them and be thankful for it.
Watch yourself, Roderick.
This is against the king's law. You've no right to make such demands.
I have every right.
You have no fucking right!
Of Roose Bolton, Warden of the North. So I will be in your hall.
This is actually pissing me off.
I will be in your courtyard. I will sit on your fucking council and be in your bedchambers if I bloody well please.
You can't do this, little bastard. You can't just do whatever.
We'll do what we were sent here to do.
You don't want to go to battle within these walls. We need to make this work.
Why should I listen to some cripple with half a face? Now, me and my men will take our place in your hall.
Because you're a warty little son of a cunt.
No. You know better than that. You know where we'll be.
This is outrageous.
Roderick!
You can't go in there.
We can and we will.
Unless you want this all to end right now. Eh? I'm the only lord here.
Come on.
You're a fourthborn! At best, you're a fucking dick of a lord. The fucking dick of a lord. The penis, what is attached to an actual lord. And a gangly fucking grotty one at that.
Griff Whitehill, that's not Lord's fourthborn. Parade
fucking
here,
fourthborns.
Like fucking hero.
It was bad enough when it was just the soldiers.
We can't live with them under our roof, soiling our house.
I know you tried to stop them, my lord. But we can only take this occupation for so long. Our people will break. And the way Griff Whitehill came in, that's clearly what he wants.
I'm no fool. I've seen the soldiers and our horse. And Whitehill's runt is at the front of the pack. So don't act as if I don't know how bad it is.
Of course not, my lord. But Griff Whitehill isn't the beginning of our troubles, or the end of them. We need to look at all the pieces. Whitehill men aren't just in our house. They've raided our lands, burnt farms, and cut down our trees. All the way from here to High Point. How do we kill a snake, then? By smashing its head. Griff isn't the head.
That sounds fun.
It's his father.
Perhaps. But Griff is here. We have access to him.
And they have Ryan.
Ryan carved those, didn't he? The way you're looking at it.
He carved these soldiers.
Ah! Hold it!
I don't care what Gwyn Whitehill may have told you at the funeral. Who knows what horrors they're putting him through, held prisoner at High Point. You can't forsake his safety.
But we have to do something. My lord.
And with both of you.
At least give us a target to aim for.
We have to push Griff and his soldiers out of Ironwrath. They're the most immediate threat.
But Roderick, what of Ryan? If you move against Griff, who knows what those wretches will do to my son?
The Whitehills know that harming Ryan, killing Ryan, would mean war. There is no turning back from that. We must secure Ironwrath, so we have a home to bring Ryan back to.
Don't forget him.
I'd never forget him, Mom.
It's decided. We take back our home.
We lost most of our men with Gregor at the Twins.
We can probably gather another 30 or 40 men.
But the Whitehills are already fortified inside Ironwrath.
Thankfully, Roderick secured an alliance with the Glenmores.
But those forces mean nothing until after the marriage.
That means we have to count on Asha and Myrra.
How?
Asha means to sail home from Essos with a company of hardened sellswords. But they're not bannermen. We'll need to pay them for it. Which is why Myrra's part to play is just as crucial. She can get us the coin we need in King's Landing.
You don't imagine we have a luxury waiting
for. Motherfuck!
Asha and Myrra are a long way from here.
I have faith in my children.
I don't think Lord Whitehall will kindly stand by while we pull ourselves together.
If we have to go to battle before we're ready, we risk losing everything. But sometimes you have no choice.
That time may indeed come, but it's not now. The Whitehills aren't ready for war.
It won't be long before you're able to take action yourself.
Well, one way or another, there's a fight brewing, so I have much to prepare, and men to train.
My lord?
Sir Roland? Don't worry, Mom. We got this.
My lord.
There may be something we can do now.
A voice from High Point, Gwyn Whitehill.
I spoke with her at the funeral.
As did I. And she's willing to meet. Away from her father's guards. I may not be your sentinel, but please consider this.
We'll be done.
It would be wise to hear what she has to say.
Arrange a meeting. What she has to say may prove useful.
I believe she can be trusted, but best use caution nonetheless.
Of course.
And I'll make sure no one else knows. For now, at least.
Good.
Handle things right with Gwyn. And she may even help us in High Point. When the time comes.
Aye. Oh, this is getting so fucking intriguing. I'm like a fucking kid in the candy shop right now. It is so great. Lead my own Game of Thrones story. Fucking shit up. Doing things terribly. Oh yeah.
I want the dove pie served with a spoon of lemon cream. We'll have to let the kitchens know. And these flowers. They're just all wrong in the Crownlands. Mira, are you listening to me?
Lady Marjorie, good tidings to you today.
Thank you, Lord Tyrion.
And you, Lady Mira, a word in private, if I may. I'll return her shortly.
Who would I be to deny Lord Tyrion?
Very soon you'll be the queen. And if you're anything like the current one, you'll deny me all you like.
Please excuse me for a moment, my lady.
I promise I won't keep you long.
You shut your fucking mouth! Lady, I've been summoned by a lord higher than you right now.
Although,
fuck off.
After tonight, I suspect I won't be her least favorite Lannister anymore.
What did you want, my lord?
There's much unpleasant business to be done today. But I bring you a bit of good news. I've arranged for the Crown to purchase Forrester Ironwood. A royal decree sits on my desk now. And I'll have my squire Podrick see to it at the first opportunity. You'll bring prosperity to your family. They're lucky to have you.
You honor me, Lord Tyrion. Only you could make such a strong gesture to House Forrester. My lord, do I still owe you a favor?
As handmaiden to the new queen, you will undoubtedly prove useful. I'm sure I'll think of something. Enjoy the festivities.
Goodbye, Lord Tyrion.
You sneaky little fuck.
Today of all days. You know I didn't want you talking to him.
I know, milady.
You're playing a dangerous game, Mira. Sarah will help me with my gown and hair. I'll deal with you after the wedding.
Fine.
Come with me, Sarah.
There you go, Sarah. Now you get your Lord Balding. I can't remember what his name is now. Lord Balding of Haircut Town. That's literally all I've got. That's terrible.
Garrett. Easy now.
Sorry. I was just keeping at the ready.
That's good. Don't lose that. I understand your uncle paid you a visit. What did he want? Not many people pass through here. What brought him this far?
Have you ever heard of the North Grove? He came to ask about it.
Is that so? Old Nan used to tell us a tale about ice dragons and trees as tall as the sky.
Fucking ice dragons.
Garrett, you have to leave all that behind.
Especially now that you're a ranger.
Aye.
I know you had told me you could stand with these men, but not every brother's a friend. If it came to it, and you were in trouble north of the wall, any of them you'd trust by your side? You know these men. Who do you want watching your back?
Finn can handle himself. I'd bring him to a fight.
I'm glad you can trust your brother. I'll remember him.
Erolt Holt of White Harbor, Corliss Wells from Stony Sept,
And finally, we've got more spawn of nobility joining us.
No.
Brit Warwick of House Whitehill.
It's the guy with the penis haircut! Make sure you're not
bringing this one to the Baltics. Garrett. Garrett, what's the matter? You know him?
He killed
my
father.
Come on, get moving.
Garrett, who is he?
That man murdered my family.
What?
Snow! See these new recruits to the Maester.
Don't do something you regret.
I'll try. I have no fucking promises. If he comes to me, though...
fucking pig farmer. I'm here because of you. Got sent to the wall for that little party I do with your family. Don't think it's over. Best
fuck off, Brick!
What are you waiting for, recruit?
Welcome to the wall. Brother.
Looking forward to it.
That's enough. I said move.
I'll be seeing you, farm boy.
Well, this has got a little bit more fucking interesting, didn't it? Didn't it? Fucking penis head. Seriously, his haircut looks like a penis knob on his head. That is his hair.
This isn't fair.
Not exactly like it, because it doesn't have like the little floof at
the
bottom.
I'll never see another wedding like this. I don't know what you did to Tyrion Lannister that made Cersei want to punish you, but it never should have affected me like this.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea any of this would happen, but what Tyrion Lannister did for me, it may have saved my family.
I hope that's true, Mira. I really do, because you don't know how furious Margaery is at you. When I was getting her dressed for the wedding, she was talking about who she could replace you with. I probably shouldn't have even told
you. Oh, no.
But I suppose you have a right to know. Tell me who it is. Why? What are you going to do to her?
Sarah!
No. It doesn't matter. It was just names. This is about you. Look. You once promised to help me with Margaery when our positions were reversed. That meant everything to me. Maybe now I'm in a position to help you. Otherwise, Margaery's going to make you leave King's Landing. You're pushing her to it, Mira.
Thank you, Sarah. I could really use a hand right now. I don't want to do this all alone.
Don't worry. We'll figure this out. I'll beg Margaery if I have to.
I like this Sarah
not
girl.
Not letting her send you home. Serving the pie.
Oi.
We're missing everything.
I know you. You were in the gardens the other night with Damien.
I fucking hope you clean the blood.
You disappeared. I have a few questions to ask you. What were you doing there with him?
Mira, you've made a mistake.
Seven hells.
You there, girl. I need a towel or a wet cloth, something.
Lord Morgren.
You'll need to find someone else. I'm not finished
with
her.
Are you sick, man? You think I have time to bother with handmaidens? Release her or I'll have Queen Cersei find you another job.
Why the worried face?
Well, I just ruined a perfectly good shirt to come to your rescue. No need to explain what that was all about.
That was kind of you. I do appreciate it.
Well, I didn't do it merely for your benefit.
Then why?
Perhaps I recognize a kindred spirit.
Morgan,
it's not every little handmaiden who can
fella.
Steal an ironwood decree with the crown right out from under my nose. Consider me impressed. My partners, I am afraid to say, felt rather differently about it.
You flatter me, my lord.
I'm only saying you have potential, my lady. Your problem is, you still think like a handmaiden. Do you even understand why Tyrion gave you the Ironwood deal? Because it wasn't out of the kindness of his heart.
I'm no fool. He wants something from me. Access to Margaery. Or perhaps he just knew he could get the cheapest Ironwood from me.
Very observant. You are no mere handmaiden. I remember what it was like to be new to this game. You feel like you're drowning, don't you? There's no one you can really trust. What you need more than anything is an ally. I could be that for you, Lady Mira. Is that something you'd be interested in?
An alliance can mean many things, my lord. I would be a fool to say yes without knowing what I was saying yes to.
Wisely put. So, let me be blunt.
Nail
it. Circumstances have put us at odds. But what if we were to work together? Control the price of Ironwood together? We could get very, very rich together. Or should I go back to Lord Whitehall, who has proven to be very interested in it?
Oh, son of a bitch! The purple wedding has occurred.
Afraid it just became a very bad time to be linked to Tyrion Lannister. Tell me that you got that Ironwood decree from him before the wedding.
Oh no. He said it was waiting for me on his desk.
What a shame. Such potential. I'm afraid any chance of our alliance has become quite impossible.
Wait! Wait!
I can get it. I'll get it back from his chamber.
That would not be an easy task, especially now. But if it were to disappear. Perhaps we could talk again.
Oh, it will. Oh, it will.
You have a good head for business, Lady Mira. It'd be terribly disappointing to see it on the end of a pike.
Gotta get that decree, yo! Shit.
Damn it!
Well, what do you expect?
Tom!
What in seven hells do you think you're doing up here? What are you thinking? You've got to leave, now.
Tom, I'm in trouble. There's something inside I need to get. If I don't, it's going to be a nightmare.
I have a feeling I shouldn't have kept that knife, though.
Trouble for me too.
Shit.
So what do we do?
I have an idea. The terrace.
The what?
I could maybe climb across the roof and drop down onto the outside terrace. It's just... I don't know, Mira. Is whatever's in there really worth risking my life for? It's not just kings who die stupidly around here.
Tom,
please.
I really
Tom.
Need your help here. I can't do this alone. Just be careful.
Wait here. I'll be at the door before you know it.
He's got a crush on me so hard. Oh my god. It's so cute. Right, I'm shipping Coldboy.
Just what do you think you're doing here? You shouldn't be anywhere near this place. Don't you know the imp has murdered the king?
I just needed to get away. After everything that's happened, it was terrible.
I'm sure you did. I'm not going to ask you again. Oi! Whoever's in there, I command you to open this door at once, in the name of the king! You! Don't move!
Sure thing.
It's me. Hurry.
Gods, that was close. I almost didn't make it back down here. Some tiles on the roof came loose.
Thank you, Tom. I could never have done this without you. I'm looking for a piece of paper. A royal decree.
Well, go on. That Lannister guard could be back with help any second. I'll keep watch outside the door.
Tom!
You can do this.
I have a feeling search the desk. It's right there.
He said that it would be on his desk.
Ah, fuck. Open.
Mira, we're running out of time.
Oh, nothing. Just a letter from Tywin Lannister. Oh, another bloody letter. Tyrion's strongbox. Oh, it must be in here.
I think the Lannister guard is back.
No, it's the other one.
Damn it, hide! I find a way to distract them.
Shit!
Stuck. I'm telling you, I heard someone in here.
Search the place. We'll find them. And after.
I hope I chose the right spot.
Keys. We can have a little look inside his lockboxes, eh?
Aye.
You did it. How?
I lit a tapestry on fire down the hall. I bought you a minute, maybe two.
Oh, thank you.
Did you find it?
Oh, I think it has to be in here. It has to be.
That one. Use.
It worked.
Nailed it! Holy shit!
Finally. Let's go.
Finally? That was the first one. You fuck.
If I catch the bastard who...
Oh, bring their bloody neck.
Holy... How did I get that in the first try? That's amazing.
We're not far now. Gwyn Whitehill may already be there.
What is this? Our ironwood trees. It's the Whitehills. You see what they've done?
Those fucking cunts! Hundreds
of years old.
Before this is done, we'll make them pay. Every last one of them.
Fucking
the White Hills need to answer for this.
I know this is Game of Thrones, but I hope to Christ the end comes with some justice.
She'll be over there. Be cautious, Milord. If she go around her father to help us, she must have some purpose.
I think she can help us. And caution's a virtue we can't afford.
Just... be wary, my lord. You see what our family's done here. Here. You might want this. You may have known each other since you were children.
Doesn't hurt to be careful.
Go on. I'll stay with the horses.
Good one, Tuttle.
It's not enough to take our wood. They must defile our homes.
Let me guess, it's subpar? That's a shit double axe. Double saw. Whatever.
Damned White Elves. Cutting down everything they see. Do they understand nothing about Ironwood?
Split beams, cracked wheels, shoddy workmanship. Clearly White Hill. This well. I remember hiding down there, playing monsters and maidens with little Naaman and Megan.
Naaman and Megan. Don't know who those people are. Maybe we'll meet them sometime. Ooh, it's a grindstone. Let's have us a look, shall we?
I can still smell the sawdust. Hear the whining of the grindstone. Such a part of my early years. So long ago.
What, you're like 25? You're old, son.
I see you haven't lost your warrior's ways. That's good. I wouldn't want to deal with someone careless.
Hello, Gwyn.
Well...
Roderick. You saw my father's work over there, didn't you? There's no way to miss it. And he won't stop. He means to do that to every inch of your land.
Damn your father. He's laid waste to this land. My land. I'll have my vengeance for this.
I brought you here so that you would see what's happening. So there's no need to make threats against my father. I come as a friend.
Do you?
Yes, I do. I wasn't sure you were even going to show. We're taking a risk, meeting like this.
Thank you for paying respects to my father and brother. And for coming tonight. It's good to see you again.
And you too, Roderick. I think we can help each other. But first...
That was a bit of a bastard, but then she covered a track.
I've heard news of Asher.
You know.
That he plans to return to Ironwrath.
That is true.
Why is he coming back? I loved him once.
Yeah.
I longed for Asher to come back. But not like this.
If you must know, he's bringing us an army.
You may think that's going to help your family. But it will only lead to more killing. I want peace between our families. No more wars. No more bloodshed. Is that what you want too?
It is what I want!
I need to hear you say
But sometimes...
It. Will you work with me?
Yes.
Sometimes...
Peace means my family will be safe. Of course that's what I want.
The years have blessed you with wisdom, Roderick. And it is good you have it. Because peace is the only hope your family has. My father is just waiting for an excuse to attack. Why do you think he sent my brother? So there will be trouble. My father will bring utter ruin on your house. Unless you let Griff feel like he's in control. I know you refuse to kiss my father's ring, but you would be wise to show more respect to Griff.
I'm not afraid of some petulant fourthborn.
You should be. Because there's a very dangerous fourthborn in your house right now.
My lord, a band of riders approach from the north.
Seven hells. My father's guards must be tracking me. If they catch us here, they'll kill you.
Then we've no time to waste. Let's get on with it.
My father is planning to make a move against your family. I don't know all the details, but he's been sending a great deal of gold to someone in King's Landing. I fear for your family, Roderick. You may think you've nothing more to lose.
Why are you telling me all this? Is it meant to frighten me? To make me bend the knee and bow my head?
No, of course not. Although that's what my father wants. And he knows you can't fight him. He knows exactly how weak you are.
What? How?
Because you have a traitor in your council. Someone who knows every detail of your circumstances.
If someone's betrayed me, I'll find them and cut their throat myself.
Deliver justice to your people however you like. You'll have to find them first. And I don't know who it is. We know you're planning to force Griff from your home. Even if it endangers Ryan's life.
What?
My father's guards are close. I need to know you'll do what I've asked. Promise me you'll submit to Griff. If you want peace between our families, it's the only way.
There's no way I can make that promise.
I could have helped you, but now, I won't be coming here again. There's been enough killing. I hope you do your part.
My lord, those riders are nearly upon us. We have to go.
What better I not be fucking you, Turtle!
What you do with it. And remember,
cunt.
I'll hear about it if you don't.
My lord?
Come along, Duncan.
It better not be you, Tuttle. Look at this fucking filth! I've had enough. Get these men. They destroyed the tapestry. They destroyed the tapestry.
Mother.
Roderick. Look at what's become of our house. You were nowhere to be found, and they just... Oh, they are vile men. Where were you? We need you here.
Mother, I went to see Gwyn Whitehill.
You did what? You would meet with the girl who once tore this house apart. Oh, I see now why you went in secret. Surely you must have known I would have counseled against it. I hope it was worth it. Well, what did she have to say?
There's a traitor in this house.
He's plotting against us. I don't know his plans, but I fear them. And the only way he'll stop is if we submit to Griff's rule of our house.
What? Would you really give up control of our house?
No!
Griff is
Fuck
already
Fuck that!
How much worse could it get?
These are dire times, but I won't kneel to a Whitehill in my own house.
Then don't kneel. Was this all? Did you learn anything more? You need to tell me.
What I've told you is nothing compared to what else I've learned. There is a traitor in our house, on our council.
No. This can't be. And all our plans to save Ryan, to save this house.
All gone.
Roderick, who could have turned on us? Times have been hard. But I never thought this would happen.
I have to say, Duncan worries me the most.
Perhaps. But what about Roiland?
Roiland?
Or Maester Ortengren? If we don't know, then we can't trust anyone. Then again, I don't know
why
we should believe anything that girl told you. The White Hills would love to sow dissent in our house with lies of traitors.
Get in there. Go on, get in there.
What do you want from me?
No, he was over there.
And Ramsay was here.
I'll play it how I want.
You will bend the knee to your liege lord.
Never. I don't kneel to bastards.
Shut your mouths and stop this at once.
Oh, look here. It's the new lord.
You're in luck. We're just getting to the best part. Little Lord Ethan's final breath. Unless you want to play the Lord of House Forrester instead.
You can't do this. You can't do this. Get out of our house right now.
We'll do as we please. Besides, we're not finished.
You must stop.
I know you've seen it before, but
It gets better every time.
Stop this, or you'll suffer the same fate as my brother.
But we can't stop now. Not before my favorite part.
Oh, please, no!
Say hello to your father.
Oh, no.
He's down.
Oh, well done, well done. I'd say he died better than the real Ethan.
Oh, better than the real Ethan.
What about you, eh? You want to be next?
Men without honor are lower than dogs.
I'd be happy to dirty my blade with your blood.
This ends now. It's over.
Make his mother watch.
No more fucking
now we'll really have some fun.
Enough.
Griff will deal with him. When he's done, he'll own this fucking house. And you'll regret what you've done here. Take your boy out.
You dare wear a beard like that? I just realized I've been very silent for the last little while. I'm sorry. But he dares wear a beard like that! And have balls. He's a cunt. A right fucking cunt. Ooh, I have a feeling though I fuck shit up. But sorry about that little bit of silence. I'm sorry. I just got really caught up in what was happening. Like, holy shit.
Wendell, pack the extra rations. Duff, make sure the quivers are full and the torches are dry. Garrett.
What's happening?
We're heading north of the wall to deliver justice to brothers turned traitor.
Oh?
They're hiding in the woods. At a place called Craster's Keep. I've been looking for volunteers.
Oh, Craster?
The cowards murdered Commander Mormon.
I'll volunteer to go.
I thank you for that. I need every sword I can get. But Britt's going to. He took his vows in the Sept. He's a brother now. I understand
in the Sept?
Why you hate him.
Southerner fucking
our blood
cunt.
Could jeopardize this mission. Too many unknowns out there. I can't have my own men killing each other.
I'm a ranger now. I've left my past behind me, Britt included.
Until you're standing next to him with a sword in your hand. That's the real test.
Fair play.
If you do come, I need to know there won't be any trouble. Even if he provokes you.
Can I count on you? I need your word, Garrett. I understand. You won't have any
nothing
trouble.
Nothing will happen.
Me. I'll hold you to that. It's a hard road to Craster's. We leave tomorrow at first light.
Now, why don't you go talk to those two? They volunteered as well. Make sure they're ready.
All right, then.
Where are my arrows?
Well, what did Jon Snow say? I don't think he likes us much.
Definitely doesn't like you, Finn.
Haven't heard him singing your praises, any.
He wants us ready for the march tomorrow.
Just give the word. I'm tired of being under Frostfinger's boot all the time.
You do know we're heading off to fight a band of murderers, right?
That's why you bring a ranger.
Point is, he doesn't want any problems with you going to Craster's.
Well, there's something you should know, then. I borrowed this from you.
What?
I just got curious. I wanted to know why your uncle was here.
It never ends with you.
Oh, didn't mean no harm, honest. I just wanted a quick look. I wasn't stealing.
You can't keep doing that, Cotter. Next time, ask.
Well, I did try. And you just said your uncle was here about Ironwood.
That's true, I did.
It was something else. I noticed this part here.
North Grove. That's just some shit story for little kids. A rumor.
No, it's not.
Of course it is. I heard it's a witch's den where they turn children into giants. Garrett, you don't actually take it seriously, do you? It's a fairy tale. For idiots. Everyone knows that.
You're wrong, Finn. It's more than a rumor. Lord Forrester found the truth. It's real.
And this says it's somewhere in the north. On the other side of the wall.
And here I thought you might have some brains, Garrett. You two deserve each other. Have fun chasing your tails.
Good. Didn't need him anyway.
What do you mean?
Finn doesn't know about the mammoths or white walkers or how to sneak past a giant.
What, and you do?
But you know, it's the things you hear about. The rumors is all. I wouldn't know myself.
Bullshit. Come on, you're
rumors
hiding something.
My ass. You're hiding something, Cotter.
I'm not. They're just things I hear around Castle Black's all. People talk, you know.
Not about the North Grove, they don't.
Well, you do. Probably heard you talking about it. Or maybe one of the recruits.
Cotter, I know you're lying. I covered for you. You owe me.
All right. All right.
He's a wildling, isn't he? He's one of them.
I've been on the other side of the wall, Garrett. You see, I live there. In the north. I'm part of the free folk.
Fucking caught it!
Called wildlings.
Holy shit.
It's crazy. I was with some other free folk. We were looking for weapons south of the wall. We got caught. So I passed myself off as a local and, well, they sentenced me here to Castle Black for stealing.
Fucking potatoes,
eh? I shouldn't be here. This isn't my place.
Are you putting me on, Cotter?
I wouldn't joke about that. They'd kill me if they found out. Are we... We still friends?
Yeah, we're good, Cotter.
I know, it's a lot to take in. And I'd understand if you were angry.
Don't worry. Bloodthirsty wildling or not, we're still brothers.
That is good to hear. At least when Mance Raider wants to boil you alive, you'll know someone in high places.
Cotter! What did I say? That shithouse you fixed is still leaking!
I'll be right there. I'm going back home. No matter what, Garrett. I've heard stories. Old tales of a secret forest within a forest. Your lord knew what he was talking about.
You know where the North Grove is?
No. But I'll help you find it. I'm deserting anyway. Heading back home. I can guide you. Keep you alive. Stick with me and I'll show you the way. Plenty of things out there want to kill you. Others want to eat you.
All right. Even if you are a bloodthirsty wildling.
I won't let you down.
Cotter! Now!
On the way! Please, don't tell anyone about me. The Watch would kill me if they found out.
You have me word, Cotter. You were nice to me from the beginning. Unlike that Finn cunt. That Finn guy. What a bastard. You'll probably find out eventually anyway. Fucking whatever. Oh, here we go.
Marine still smells like shit, even outside
back
the
back in Essos.
We'll find Croft here somewhere. You alright?
Never better. Back under the Mad King, they used to say death by sword was a sweet kiss. But fire would fuck you hard.
Funny.
No, not very.
I'll go find Kent.
That actually was funny.
I need you to tell me the truth. I've come a long way to bring you home. Back in that cave, you made a choice. You must have thought only one of us was going to survive. Now, it's not a fair question to ask, but I need to know.
I fought beside you, Uncle, too many times to count. I figured you could handle yourself. Beskar was the one face to face with a dragon.
I appreciate the respect, but it's not about that. Look, I can't blame you if your feelings about me are conflicted.
Yeah, I went for Beskar because I shipped her.
Your family exiled you to the
Still shipping it. Fuck you guys.
I swore an oath to your
mother. Still shipping that.
Sailed halfway around the world to bring you back safe. And I'd be damned if some dragonfire or your foul decisions are going to stop me. Are we clear? I'm here to help you. To protect you.
I'm sorry, Malcolm. I did you wrong.
Well, it's good of you to say so. But words are wind, Asher. It's choices that define who you are.
Asher, I know where Croft is.
Saving Bay! That's what I'm doing. Saving Bay. Fuck you. You got a cock.
This Croft.
And you're my uncle.
Do you know?
That's just too well. That's just all sorts of wrong.
We're friends.
Yeah, we are. We are.
Bay is not.
Great friends.
My uncle.
Asher fucking Forrester. Son of a poxy whore. You have some balls walking into my tent after all these years with that mama's monkey grin on your face.
He does have a mama's monkey grin, though.
Well, that went well. Great friends indeed.
All right, maybe I deserve that.
That's not even a taste of what you deserve. You never understood consequences, Asher. One stupid mistake cost me an eye. But you never learn. You figured you'd steal from me and I'd just forgive you? Not a fucking chance. So how are you going to pay me back? Your eye? Your hand? Or how about your tongue?
Croft, no!
Be reasonable.
I am reasonable! I'm letting him fucking choose.
Look, Croft, what we did was wrong. I'm sorry for that.
You heard him. Now let him go.
You're not getting out of this with a fucking apology.
Croft, I deserve your anger as much as Asher.
Don't worry, Beskar. You're next. Now choose, or I slice off your balls, Asher.
No, not the balls.
Hey. Praise my trust. There's a price to be paid.
Let him go!
Enough!
You fucking bastard. Take my eye, then. I don't need two to kill you.
Done.
Oh, that was bloody beautiful. Fucking Asher. You were pale as a snow bear's ass.
you motherfuck!
You bloody bastard.
This is why people steal your shit and take off in the night.
Come on, you assholes. Have a drink.
I like this guy. I like this guy.
Best wine.
Also,
your friend has an interesting follow his sense rule. Of humor.
So come on, you assholes! Have a drink!
Okay? You're a long way from young guy.
We have a proposition for you.
We? You're hardly the usual rabble these two travel with.
He's Asher's family.
Your sword was always the quickest, Croft. I need you and your men to fight for me in Westeros.
We need your hellhounds. 100 good men.
Am I in a hobby's tip? Would I ever go back to Westeros?
I've got it good right here. Her grace pays good coin. I've got wine, women. I've got my own tent. And it never fucking snows.
If you don't join me, my family will die. I'm here because I need you, Croft.
Oh, shit. I don't even know your fucking family and you're breaking my heart. I swear by the warrior, I'd help you if I could. But it's not up to me.
Not to you?
Sworn to Daenerys Targaryen.
Oh, fuck!
My sword at her feet. For now.
Perhaps we could talk to her.
She's a little busy right now, commanding a fucking siege. Her enemies are nailing children up on posts for 100 miles, and a bloody dragon's gone missing.
But I know where to find her dragon.
Unfucking likely. You expect me to believe you've just happened to have seen the one fucking dragon loose in the world?
Orange eyes, as big as my head, scales all black.
That doesn't prove anything. Enough of this nonsense. We're done here, Asher. You two back in my life. Spinning your tails again.
I've got proof, you old fuck. Tell me what this is, if not a bloody dragon tooth.
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick.
Croft. I've seen a dragon.
Oh, bugger me with a bloody spear. If you're lying about this.
Fair enough.
Holy shit.
Come on, you son of a bitch. The beast's name is...
I wouldn't know, bastard.
Hear about him right away. Don't think
I got this.
To charm her
I wouldn't know a dragon tooth from a basilisk dick. God damn. Hilarious. I wonder what would have happened if I showed him the fucking dragon burn, though. I don't know a dragon burns from a fucking basilisk scum stain. That's all I got. A basilisk disc. Dick.
Big day Dick. Tomorrow, isn't it? Off to Craster's Keep. Assuming you're not too busy looking for your North Grove.
I thought you didn't believe in it.
Not saying I do. But if it was real, can you trust Potter with it? You ask me. There's just something off about him. Aside from him being an oily thief, I mean.
Potter's not a bad soul.
I trust him.
I trust him.
Even after he tried stealing your map? Do as you like. But if we're going out there tomorrow, in the middle of fucking nowhere, I want to know who I can trust.
Finn, get back on watch until your relief arrives.
They're late.
You think Mance Rayder is going to wait for them?
Right. Asshole.
And Tuttle, you've got torches that have gone out. Keep them lit. Let the wildlings know we're still home.
Fucking hell. Oh, I'm going to fucking run into Brit, aren't I?
This one's still good.
Yeah, it is.
If anyone tries coming over the wall, well, those will stop them.
Just a quick check to make sure that I had not missed anything. Anything? Oh my god. Alright, it's all sweet.
Oh, man could freeze to death up here.
At least that's on fire still.
Uncle Duncan brought these from Ironrath. Wonder if I'll ever see it again.
Maybe.
That's ironwood for sure.
You could have fucking picked one up.
This must hold up the lift. Probably fall apart if it wasn't frozen together.
That is true. Look at the ice wall.
Solid ice.
Nothing can melt it.
Oh, it's Pig farmer.
It's fucking you.
A 300-mile wall, and you're still in my way.
I figured we'd settle things on the way to Craster's. But this is even better.
Jon Snow can't hold your hand now.
Oh, fuck you, Brit.
Still have some fighting spirit left in you, huh? I did duty to my lord back on that bloody farm. If for doing a proper job of it, what'd I get? Banished to the fucking wall! I never did tell you about your father, did I? We bled him at first, like a pig. Seemed only fair, he should feel this like. Near the end,
Brit,
he could
stop.
Barely breathe. Kept begging
Brit,
us
stop.
To leave your sister alone. So I made sure he was still alive when she started screaming. It was the last thing your father ever heard. The more we sliced, the worse it got.
You're not worth it. I didn't come here to chat, you fucking cunt.
Too bad your father didn't fight like that. Might still be alive. And I thought you were going to make this easy.
I don't want to fight you.
Stop, dammit! I don't want to fight you!
What's the matter? Don't you want to make your father proud? Let's see if you scream like you...
Scream like my what? Me fucking sister? You're fucked.
You got lucky, pig farmer. You're going to slaughter me, like my man back at your farm. At least let me have my sword. Keep it interesting. Or are you afraid?
Take your sword. When you die, you'll know you weren't good enough.
So noble, you fucking cunt.
Alright, let's fucking do this! B. X! To the side! Oh, that's gonna fucking hurt. Yet, I want him to suffer. You fucker.
Let's fucking finish it. Go on.
Nice. No.
We're done here.
Not worth my time. Don't.
Finn!
Oh, you fucking little bitch! You tattle fucking tail! God damn. And here I was protecting Finn. Fuck. Fuck. Bloody fuck. Oh, look out.
These people are all scared, my lord. The White Hills have driven them away from the Ironwood Forests.
Out of the way!
It ends
today. Now
they
come here, starving, looking for food. Food we don't have to spare. How can we support an army and reclaim our place in the north if we can't even feed a handful of peasants? Our backs are at the wall again. And this won't get better on its own.
These are hard times, to be sure. Harder than I've ever seen. But I'll do whatever it takes to get us through it.
We'd better hope we figure something out. With those Whitehill bastards in our house, we must be wary.
Come on, you!
Let me go! You can't do this!
Good. You're here. Look. Look at this! Did you see what this girl did? She attacked my man like an animal.
Bloody bit me.
Yeah, now it's her turn. She's gonna get what she has coming to her.
You take your hands off me, fucking sister!
She's your sister.
She bit your man. How did that happen? What did he do to her?
That doesn't matter. It matters what she did.
Oh, it fucking does matter! I'm sorry.
I saw him stealing from our kitchen, and I told him to stop. He laid his hands on me, so I bit him.
Bloody wench!
I was only doing what had to be done.
I warned you not to mistreat my men. Someone will have to answer for this. Do you hear me? Don't make this ugly.
Your men are out of control. That's the problem here.
It's your people who don't know the order of things. This girl's as untamed as a wildling.
Don't listen to him, Roderick.
And if you can't rein her in, yeah, what about the rest of them? It's about time she saw her real lord again.
Are you afraid of a young girl with all the armed soldiers you
what?
Have?
What? I'm not afraid. I want order. But this house...
You want order?
And the problem starts at the top, order. Roderick.
Watch
I'll
your
give
tone,
you a
boy.
Fucking order.
You yourself had the gall to strike one of my men. And that's the real problem with you foresters. You're too fucking proud. Always have been. It was bad enough when you were above us. And now it's even worse. Because you don't see how far you've fallen.
Still you're high enough to look down at
you're
you.
You're nothing now but a fucking shitty fourthborn.
A girl who knows how to speak the truth of things.
No. Yes. A girl who should know her station. That's how
oh, you do not touch my sister.
Oh, foolish Roderick. Now I'll have to put you in your place. You will learn some fucking humility. Or this won't be the last lesson I teach you, foresters!
Have you no honor? I'll run you through for that. I'll cut you down like straw men.
Take him, Roiland.
My bloody pleasure. I'll fucking kill you myself.
No. Make him watch this. I bet this makes you angry, eh? You probably want to get up and hit me. But we know how that would go, don't we? Now, are you going to be a good little forester, learn your lesson, and stay down?
Fuck!
I said, get down! All the way down.
Get up, Roderick!
Stay down, my lord.
Your brother defied Ramsay Snow. He didn't know his place, but we made damn sure he learned. I'll probably have to teach Talia. Unless you're a good little forester, you'll learn your place and stay down. Some forester is going to learn their lesson today.
You don't have to do that, Lord Griff.
Don't you dare! You stay down! Stay in the mud like a dog!
This is my place!
You fool!
Oh, Lord!
What? Bloody cripple! Are you fucking deaf?
You'll never keep the foresters down.
Hold there, or you're next.
Please, Lord Griff, not the arm. If you persist, Lord Roger may lose it.
Ah.
You're on fucking notice, Griff.
Down.
Tell me!
Will you be a good little forester? Oh, you can't.
I command you!
You command no one, you fourth-born cunt!
You hear me? I'm in charge here! No! I alone rule this house. Don't think this is over, Roderick! You'll see! I will make you suffer for this!
You little bitch! You little fucking bitch! Oh, you're mine. You're fucking mine! I'll fucking have you.
My boy.
Careful, he's badly injured.
Roderick!
I'll fucking have you.
He didn't let him do it. He couldn't keep you down.
You were brave, but there will be consequences, my son. We both know that.
Fuck the White Hills. Fuck them. Fuck the Boltons. Fuck the White Hills. Fuck them all. Ooh, next episode's gonna be well fun. Oh my god. Oh, it's still raining. We're still in iron wrath.
Do you see that? Standing up to Griff has made him harsh. More severe. He could have killed you. But what you did, the strength you showed us. You looked like yourself again. It was good to see you.
We'll all fight back in time. We'll take back our house.
I know we will. And when you're better, things will be different.
Not just when I'm better.
I asked Ethan not to change who he was. I tried to make him promise me. I now know that was childish of me. I'm ready to change now. I'm willing to do anything to help our family. I mean it, Roderick. I don't care what. I'll do it.
That's good. I'm sure a time will come when our house will call upon you to do what's necessary. But that time is not now.
And I'm sure the others will do whatever it takes as well. What you did, provoking Griff, it hasn't taken our house to war just yet. But
no one can know the future. Whatever tomorrow brings, Talia, the foresters will stand tall.
We did it. I can't believe it. What are you waiting for?
Keep it.
I can't.
What? After everything, we just...
I can't burn it.
It's the writ! It gives us our iron word.
The Khaleesi will see you now.
Oh, oh, oh! Oh, damn!
So, Asher Forrester, if you presume to speak of my dragons, choose your words carefully.
Oh, shit! Next episode's gonna be awesome! Damn! God damn! Next time on Game of Thrones.
What have you done?
Holy shit!
Frostfinger is calling for your head. Tell me Britt's death was an accident.
Mira,
it was.
What are you doing? Mira, just tell me what's going on. What are you hiding from me?
We are weak. We have no allies. Gwyth will make us pay for your defiance.
There's been a raven from Lord Whitehill. He's invited us to High Point.
Drogon wouldn't have attacked without reason.
By order of the Queen!
Fuck you and your Queen!
Deal with your friend.
Nothing ever stays in the past, Asher.
Harriet. It's time to go.
Oh, fuck. All right. Wow. Such a margin. 51% of us decided to save Beskar. And 51.1% of us are bitches. Defied Marjorie. Well. I'm looking at you, 51.1%. Y'all bitches. Eh-hee. 68 walked away from Brit. Good job. 32.4% stood up to Griff. That means that I'm gonna have to math that, aren't I? Uh, 67.6% of people are bitches. Oh, math! And 70% of us kept the Ironwood Decree. That is easy mode, but it seems fitting, in all honesty. It seems fitting. Anyway, you know what's up right now. This is me, Butter, playing some Game of Thrones for you. I fucking love your faces. And check it out.